in Bermuda, I feel refreshed and revived, ready to praise the Lord together with my family here and virtually. Welcome to First Church West Springfield. We are so glad to be able to be in worship together, both in person, socially distanced, and virtually. It is May 29th, Memorial Day weekend. It is also Faith in Action Sunday. And so you should know that we shorten our Faith in Action Sunday. It's the fifth Sunday of every time there's a fifth Sunday in the year. We do Faith in Action Sunday. I'll talk more about it during our message time, which will be a short reflection, not a whole message. It is today. We'll be doing some great things together. The service will end early for those of you who are virtual in the sanctuary, and we will resume and have other things to do in worship, in action, when we finish the recording. We'll still be worshiping in different areas. The other things I want to say is thank you so much to Reverend Vincent Jordan and his dear partner, Natalie. Thank you, church family, for receiving them and welcoming them. Thank you so much to one of our church members who watered my salad garden faithfully. I came back to beautiful sprouts of arugula and other things because she was so darling to just go and tend to my salad garden that I've been working on from seeds, and it's a long story. But thank you. We have some important dates happening in June. Next week is June already. It's Homecoming Sunday, which is also Pentecost. So we're asking, if you remember, don't not come if you don't remember. But if you remember and are excited to wear red, yellow, or orange, like flames for Pentecost, then do that. A lot of us will do that. A lot of us, well, you know, we'll see. But so we invite you to consider wearing red, yellow, or orange for the flames because it's Pentecost Sunday. But it's also Homecoming Sunday. After service, we'll have an ice cream social, and it's going to be a really great time together. That's June 5th. June 12th is our celebration Sunday. The children will take care of everything. I don't know about the music though. I think we still to maintain our worship experience. But the children are taking care of everything else. And we're really excited to have the young people just participating and being willing to lead worship on the 12th. That is our celebration Sunday. And then we're having our church picnic after church that same day. It's going to be at School Street Park in Iowa. Yes, after service. And so we're really excited about having our church picnic and celebration Sunday on the 19th. It's Father's Day, of course, and it's Juneteenth. And so we'll have a Juneteenth Sunday. And on the last Sunday of the month, last but not least, June 26th, we will be celebrating Pride Sunday. And so if you need any reminder of those Sundays, the June newsletter is ready. Diane has done a marvelous job making sure we have all of this great information and more in the June newsletter. So there are some at this entry table. There's some on the name tag table as well. And you can have it electronically if you haven't received it yet. Electronically, but I know Mary Pat sends that out as well. So there's a lot of great things happening. Wear your mask if you see fit to do so. If you choose not to, then that's fine too. We ask you to use your very cautious discretion in making those decisions for yourself. Lastly, no matter who you are, and no matter where you are on life's journey, you are welcome.
Good morning, everyone here and somewhere over there. My name is Donna Fiorentino. I'm a 22-year member of this open and affirming, loving church family. If you are able, please stand and join me in the call for worship. Clap your hands, all you people. Shout to God. Loud songs of joy.
For God, our most high, is the gospel.
You
our womb. We remain hopeful in you.
Guide us in our faith and our actions today and forever.
Please stand together and sing our praise song, which is in the New Century Hymnal, This Is My Song, number 591.
Every sign. His lightning lights up the world, the earth seethes and trembles. The mountains melt like wax before the Lord of all the earth. The heavens proclaim his righteousness, and all peoples see his glory. All who worship images are put to shame, those who boast in idols. Worship him, all you gods. Zion hears and rejoices, and the villages of Judah are glad because of your judgments, Lord. For you, Lord, are the most high over all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. Let those who love the Lord hate evil, for he guards the lives of his faithful ones and delivers them from the hand of the wicked. Light shines on the righteous and joy on the upright in heart. Rejoice in the Lord, you who are righteous, and praise his holy name. And God add his blessing to these words.
Amen. And let us stand together and sing for the last time this month our song of the month for May. Let's talk.
Expresses a hope for lasting peace among all nations, races, and cultures. And we just sang Let's Talk. That urges us to go out and tell the good news and share God's message of hope. I love to sing praises and worship God in that way. People have used music to worship together for a long, long time. This morning, you'll hear about how the Apostle Paul did just that. So Paul and Silas got in trouble and were put in jail because some people didn't believe what they said about God. But once they got into jail, they started singing praises to God in jail. They knew they were not alone, even when times were tough. And I think we can all agree we've had a tough week, a tough month, and a tough couple of years. Their faith was so strong. When they sang, they showed many other people how wonderful it was to believe in Jesus. So I want you all to take a clipboard and some colored pencils. They have a coloring sheet that says, "Don't worry, be happy." And that may run counter to many of our concerns and run-ins with bad news. I was substituting in the public schools this week, and I know there was a lot of anxious parents, anxious teachers, anxious kids. So it may seem counter that we're saying, don't worry, be happy. When an earthquake broke the chains that Paul and Silas were put into in jail, the guard got nervous that they had escaped. So he was scared, the guard. When he found them still in jail, they said, what did they say? Don't worry. So we would like you to write don't worry in the speech bubble. Color this picture and remember that in God, we have a way, a good way, to know that we don't have to worry as long as our trust is in God. Let's pray. Thank you, dear God, for never leaving us, especially in our times of trouble, loneliness, and fear. Help us to show our faith in you to other people we meet. We lift up our songs of praise to you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
We're going back to our seats.
We've now come to the time in our worship service that we call offering. This is the time where we acknowledge what God has given us, and we also acknowledge that we have the opportunity to worship by giving back a portion of what God has given us to the works of the church and for God's people. And so we ask that you consider what you are able to give and know that you have four options to do so. You can do so electronically by making your offering to firstchurchws.org and clicking on the donation button to make your offering. You can send it in the U.S. mail. You can drop it off at the church, either to the office Monday through Thursday, or just put it in the mail slot on any day. And you can also participate in person when the plate goes around. May we have someone to and bring the offering plate around. Yes, our treasurer will do so. Thank you so much, Bruce. And so I invite you to feel this opportunity to share what God has given. It's offering time. So I'm going to encourage you all in your own time to read Acts 16, verses 16 through 34. I'm not going to read that today. I think that Psalm 97 is so beautiful. I want to read the last couple of verses of Psalm 97 and then read Psalm 98 and then just chat a little bit about what's happening. So please hear the word. I will read Psalm 97 starting at verse 10. Let those who love the Lord hate evil. He guards the lives of those who are faithful to him. He saves them from the power of sinful people. The light of his favor shines on those who do what is right. Joy comes to those whose hearts are honest. You who are godly, be glad because of what the Lord has done. Praise him because his name is holy. In Psalm 98, sing a new song to the Lord. He has done wonderful things. By the power of his right hand and his holy arm, he has saved his people. The Lord has made known his power to save. He has shown the nations that he does what is right. He has shown his faithful love to the people of Israel. People from one end of the earth to the other have seen that our God has saved us. Shout to the Lord with joy, everyone on earth. Burst into joyful songs and make music. Make music to the Lord with the harp. Sing and make music with the harp. Blow the trumpets, give a blast on the ram's horn. Shout to the Lord with joy. He is the King. Let the ocean and everything in it roar. Let the world and all who live in it shout. Let the rivers clap their hands. Let the mountains sing together with joy. Let them sing to the Lord, because he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the nations of the world in keeping with what is right and fair. On this Memorial Day weekend, we make it a point as Americans to remember, to give a memorial time and attention to those who have served in the military, who have gone on and had served in their lives before. And we honor the service that has been provided for our safety in our country. But we can't ignore what's happening in our country with the lack of safety for the young people, the old people, the people who go to school, church, the grocery stores, and think they're safe and end up not. We can't not recognize the pains that are happening for people that we may not even know but are connected to in our humanity and in our Americanism. We feel sad. Sometimes we feel helpless. Sometimes we feel unable to do much. But I'm here to tell you today that as we continue to pray and know that God is still on the throne, and that God cannot fail, and that the words in the book of Psalm are absolutely true, that God is wondrous, God is mighty, God is capable, and even though bad things happen, we must still find joy. Joy in knowing who God is, joy in knowing that God is with us, and that God is still in the miracle business. We have to know that when we look at the sorrowful things and the traumatic things that happen in the world and in our country, things outside of our country, but I'm talking specifically about our country today, as we remember and honor those who have served to protect our freedom and liberty, that there are things that we can't do. And so as we, as a church community in West Springfield, are celebrating faith and action on this day and every fifth Sunday of the year, we remember that there are things that we can actively do as worship, but actively do as a sense of healing and contributing to the good in the world. Everything doesn't always have a happy ending, but there are moments that we can do by, there are moments that we can have by doing together good things for others. And we at First Church West Springfield, we do it regularly, but we take this time, like on our Faith in Action Sundays, to be super duper intentional to work our mission as ministry in worship. So today we'll be doing two actual activities. We will have an on-site activity and an off-site activity, and those activities will be on-site to create hygiene and toiletry bags for those who are needy. So we have the things, the content to go inside these hygiene bags, and we'll invite those who would like to be on site to do that, to create the bags, put them together and get them ready so that they can be distributed over time. And then we will have an off-site activity at the laundromat in the Price Right Plaza in West Springfield, that's Union Avenue. And we'll be going to the laundromat and we'll bring the laundry pods and dryer sheets, and we're just gonna have ministry and fun together with people who are at the laundromat. We're going to just be with our neighbors, our real neighbors. And I brought my laundry because, you know, I don't have a clothes dryer in my new home yet. So I washed everything this morning and I brought it with me so I can be a customer and be really in there with everyone. But we're bringing treats and we're bringing activities and we're bringing laundry stuff and we're bringing quarters. I mean, we're going all in for action. But I want you to remember that there are still ways that we can find solace, find comfort, find joy, even in the midst of all the hard things in the world. We can be together, we can do for others, and those things do bring us closer in connection, which is what God wants for us. It allows us to reach out and give and help others, which is what God wants for us. And as long as we know that we are doing these things, it affords us an opportunity to really nurture our insides when we know that there's struggle with what's going on, to provide an opportunity for God to come in and rest in our souls, so that when we think about the devastation that has happened recently in our own country and in other countries as well, that we can trust in God, that we can trust that God can, and we can trust that even in those moments that it's okay for us to find ways to be happy. And so we're going to sing together as we leave out and go into our two activities, Don't Worry, Be Happy. But before we do that, I want you to say together with me two statements. I want you to say together, we trust that we are doing our best.
We trust that we are doing our best.
And we trust in God to do the rest.
And we trust in God to do the rest.
Please stand as you're able. See the words in your bulletins if you don't know them already. Let us sing together as we go and do Faith in Action. Don't worry, be happy.
Here's a little song I wrote. You might want to sing it, don't worry.